Restaurants are required to have a grease trap. It catches all the grease and fats in their wastewater before it reaches the sewer. Over time, those grease traps get clogged with pounds and pounds of calcified grease. It's my job to remove that stuff by hand.
This particular restaurant's trap is a 5x5 foot cube located under the parking lot. Rick will have to descend into it and break up the built-up fats and oils before they back up into the local sewer and create a much larger problem that would overwhelm the system, sending untold amounts of waste into the streets. Not only is this job disgusting, they also have a limited window of time to get it done.
The big thing today is, right, the restaurant opens at noon time.
Yeah.
So we've got to be done by noon. Like, you got to get the cleans, the smells up.
Okay, so this, guys, I was told is the manhole. Oh, look at all the fat on the walls.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
First thing you're seeing is grease, like oil. It's that brown, like I just fried some chicken oil flowing.
Restaurants produce up to 250 pounds of grease every week. And when it's combined with cooking oils and fat, it turns into a stomach-churning substance called fog.
Fog is gross. It's fat, it's butter, meats, and oils.
It's everything that's scraped out of a pan. It gets poured down kitchen drains and then gets mixed with wastewater.
Fog can wreak havoc inside a sewer. It quickly solidifies, coating the pipes and forming giant clogs. But the grease traps keep fog out of the sewer, thanks to a relatively genius design. The wastewater from sinks and dishwashers enter here. Grease and food particles sink to the bottom, while the cooking oils float to the top. This leaves the fog-free water in the middle, where it can be safely pumped out into the sewer pipes. Or at least that's the theory.
So what we have here at this setup is we have a kitchen, creates a lot of grease. The grease goes into this tank right below our feet, and sometimes you get water and other things mixed in with the grease, and it's supposed to separate the water and just leave the grease. And right now, because the pumps aren't working, we're getting grease and water mixed together. So it's supposed to filter off all the bad stuff and just leave the grease. And now nothing's coming out. We don't clear the clog and get this flowing again, then unfortunately all that fat and grease can collect and come up through the manhole and end up in the parking lot. Yeah, big slip and slide. People wouldn't like it.
To scrape out the solid layer of fat and grease, Rick first needs to remove around 1,500 gallons of stagnant water and rancid cooking oil.
Now, truck's coming to pump all the extra water out for us so I can see to scrape the walls, because I can't scrape the walls and collect the fat because it's all then going to float. So we need to remove a lot of the water out of there.
It's 9 o'clock and we want to be done by 11. So we're going to be tight on time. Today we're going to hustle.
Oh, look at that.
Oh. Yeah, that's a pretty rancid smell.
With most of the oil and stagnant water sucked out, Rick can now enter the grease trap. Inside, he'll need to remove over 1,000 pounds of solid grease and fat that's 5 inches thick, and it's caked all along the walls and ceiling.
What I'm gonna end up doing is taking 5-gallon buckets and a shovel and scraping the walls down, bucketing it up, buckets, and then pulling it up, and it gets dumped in the excavator.
Along with the grease and fat, Rick will also need to remove rotting pieces of food, which release methane, a gas 30 times more potent than carbon dioxide. So for his safety, Rick wears specialized sewer diving equipment.
I'm wearing a full face mask that'll seal to my hood, and I've got the same comms in this, same, you know, breathing apparatus. It's just a mask because I can't fit down in the hole with everything in there with a helmet on. So I'm just setting my air pressure to about 120 PSI. So that's 120 pounds for the regulator.
Are you sure that thing's gonna zip up?
Yeah. This is how you try and keep your suit somewhat clean. I got broad shoulders.
This is an incredible outfit.
I'm going down and that way.
Okay.
Now that he's suited up, Rick will descend into the grease pit, where he'll try to remove months of fried food byproduct from the walls.
Bucket coming down. Up in the bucket.
Back in Mystic, Connecticut, diver Rick has been dropped into his very own version of sewage hell. An underground grease trap that's clogged with over a month's worth of fat and grease.
Oof. Just got a whiff of that. That's grease.
It's so gross in there. Like, you can't describe, like, the ceiling has, like, fatsicles coming down, like little icicles of fat.
One of the byproducts of a working grease trap is hydrogen sulfide, a noxious gas that smells like rotten eggs.
Bucket coming up.
Rick has less than 3 hours to get the grease level down before it seeps into the city's sewer pipes and clogs up the entire block.
Here we go. Taco Tuesday.
There you go.
The quicker I get it done, the quicker I can get out of there.
Guys, give me the bucket. I need to get out of here.
We lost you on comm.
It's vital that my comm systems are working properly. If I can't get air to communicate with my team, we have a major issue.
For his safety, the team immediately pulls Rick out of the trap.
Just sit up here, Rick.
Yep,
I got you.
I
got you, Rick. Just stay right there. Stay right there. Come on, guys, take my hat off. Wire kind of popped out of his hat and just kind of broke off as he was going in. You know, it's a tight fit, so.
With his comms working again, Rick heads back into the trap.
Roger, good on comm.
Rick and the team might have solved one problem.
That's cooking grease.
But now they've got a bigger one, a time crunch.
So we have a restaurant here, so obviously they want to be open and people who eat here don't want to see this. So we're kind of rushing the clock.
Oh my God, this is so disgusting.
That's sick.
Rick shoveled nearly 70 pounds of fat and grease out of the restaurant's underground grease trap.
You might want to wash your hands after that.
Oh.
And a little all natural cream cheese. It's organic, locally sourced, good source of protein.
That's everything bagel spread right there. A little bit of everything.
I got you, Rick. I got it.
With over 70 pounds of grease removed, Rick and his team face another challenge.
Want a hug?
They need to move fast to get everything cleaned up before customers start arriving. The fat and grease are taken off-site to be sealed in a container and safely disposed of. The work area is then hosed and thoroughly scrubbed.
You got to spray them. What?
Take a spray.
And Rick, he needs to clean off as much of his equipment as possible.
From the bathroom, we have a hose running. So the hose is fresh, clean water. We have a trough filled with 10% bleach solution to clean any bacteria. And then from there, it's kill all the germs and then use a degreaser and scrub down all that grease and fat sticks to the suit. I was trying to protect it and save it. Can I get a plug for this and then I gotta rinse it? It's a gross job, right? No one wants to do it, but someone has to do it and it's what we do. Clean my soul.
No crew or customers were hurt in today's greasy mission, but unfortunately, there was one casualty.
The suit seen better days and pretty stanky, so it's going bye-bye. Kind of want to drink this right now. Is that bad? So this is the insider secret for dealing with these things. So you either get some essential oil or a nice rub, and you just put a dab of it right under your nose. So it's just a way of not smelling it and smelling nice rosemary all day.